Hello everyone, my name is Vivek and I'm from K4 Matrix. In this video, I will execute this Python script in techplot, which will create a point cloud data file. And I will use that file in pointwise to cluster the mesh cells. Now the geometry that we'll be using here is a backward facing step. So now here it is connecting to a techplot session that already has a data set loaded. So if there is no data set loaded, then the program won't move further. So now once it is connected to a techplot session, so then it will define the variables. That is, it will define the momentum field variable and two state variables, that is pressure and density. So now once the variables are defined, so it will calculate the cross flow velocity using the CFD analyzer. Note that you can utilize this method to generate the point cloud data with the variable of your interest. So for this particular example, we are just using cross flow velocity. So now it will use the CFD analyzer once again to calculate the cell volume, and it will calculate the cell center locations as well. So now these cell center locations will be the locations of the point sources. So now once that is done, it will gather all the variables that has been calculated. And then it will calculate an approximate cell edge length. Now this is done by taking the cube root of the cell volume that was calculated a little earlier. So now once the cell edge lengths have been calculated, it will set a cutoff value, that is the 90th percentile. Now in all those edge length values that was calculated, whichever exceeds 90% of the data value, so it will generate a new edge length. That is, here it is finding out how many cells exceed the cutoff, and the new edge length is calculated here. That is, it will be half of the previous edge length. So once this process is done, then it will start to write a PCD file. So here it is starting to write the PCD file, and here it will write all the data for each source point, that is the location and the new edge length value of the cell which has the source point. So once that is done, the program exits, and this PCD file will be saved in the directory where your Python program is there. So now I'll open techplot. So I load this zplt file. So you can see the backward facing step geometry here. Now I'll go to scripting by techplot connections, and I'll check the accept connections checkbox. I'll close this. Now I'll open Thorny. Now I'll open the Python script that I showed you earlier, and I'll run the script. So it says here that it is creating the PCD file. Okay, so it has created a PCD file. Now I'll open pointwise. So I have opened this backward facing step here. Now I'll go to file, import sources. So I'll import the point cloud data file. Click OK. So if I select the sources here, so you can see the source points. So now I'll select the two blocks here. I'll go to examine its length. I'll add a cutting plane. So this is how the cells looks like in the inlet region and near the step. So now I'll close this, and keeping these two blocks selected, I'll initialize the block. So you can see the cell generation here. Okay, so now keeping these two selected, I'll go back to examine edge length and I'll add a cutting plane. So now you can see the difference here. So the cells have been clustered in the inlet region and near the step. So this concludes this video. Stay tuned for more.